So the department has existed for over 100 years. It was started in 1905. It has been historically very important because it's able to feed off New York City's strengths. So it's sort of a conduit department where it's able to feed off the financial strength of New York City, make that into relevant products, and then figure out the technologies which can then be used elsewhere.
I think that chemical engineering is more unique than most other single departments in the engineering school. And this is true because most of the other departments have a physics base for their science. And we clearly have both the physics and the chemistry.
Historically, we've been a little bit different from some of the other chemical engineering departments because we put a very large emphasis on applied chemistry.
Chemical engineering at Columbia is special in that we have a relatively small department size, and we tend to have close relationships among the students and the faculty.
We have a core faculty which is distinguished and is involved in all kinds of research.
Columbia is one of the top research institutions in a number of areas, not just in engineering. So we have top scientists in engineering, in physical sciences. Students are learning from folks who are creating new knowledge in all of these areas, and there's just no experience like it.
They get broad spectrum jobs, they get very high-end jobs because we're teaching them portable professions.
Yeah, there are a number of specialty chemical companies that are in the greater New York City area. So that includes pharmaceutical companies, as well as specialty polymer companies and the like. And this has provided a great backdrop for us in developing the courses that we offer here at Columbia.
There are people tied to IBM. There are people tied to GE. If you look across the river, Merck, Johnson & Johnson, Bristol-Myers Squibb are all obvious connections that we have.
Chemical engineering is exciting at this time because it's really central to many of the grand challenges facing humankind. The major issues that we'll be solving in the next century, often chemical engineering will be a major part of it. For example, having clean water for all, renewable energy, maintaining our environment, as well as just general engineering solutions to improve our lifestyles. Chemical engineering is really at the center of all of that.